Josh from Chicago wants to know, how do you feel after a hypnosis session? Stick around, and I'll answer that now. It depends. It's like asking how do you feel after eating at a restaurant. There are too many variables to give a blanket answer that covers all experiences at all restaurants. I suppose it really depends on the hypnotist that you choose to work with. What sort of vibe do you get from them? In other words, do you like them? Or is there something about them that makes you uneasy? Do you know anyone who has used their services? If so, would they use them again? If you don't know anyone who has used their services, does the hypnotist have testimonials from some of their clients? Is the hypnotist able to answer your questions in a satisfactory way? If you want a litmus test to discover if the person you're speaking with may know what they are doing, ask them these two questions. What is a somnambulistic state? And can you explain what a transderivational search is? I'm going to give you the answer to these questions so you know if they've answered correctly, if they are able to answer at all. A somnambulistic state is where a hypnosis subject is interactive, can walk, talk, etc., and will respond well to most non-objectionable suggestions. It is also the state that sleepwalkers are in. Either answer is acceptable. A transderivational search, TDS for short, is the process of finding meaning in what you are experiencing. For example, if I ask you to think of a cat, your unconscious searches your memory files to find the meaning of cat and then delivers the result to your conscious mind. If the human you are speaking with cannot come close to explaining these two terms, find a human who can. I have officially been hypnotized numerous times by reputable hypnotists, and my experience has always been superb. I have been able to achieve the goal of the sessions, and I always feel refreshed, energized, motivated yet calm, and stress-free after each hypnosis session. I can also speak for the thousands of clients I have worked with over the past 3 decades. I have never had a client who did not have a pleasant experience with hypnosis. I have had clients who had to work through some very traumatic memories and emotions, and we knew that was going to happen before we started the session. But they always left our session feeling positive and better than when they arrived. As for how humans feel when they leave a session from other hypnotists, I would hope they feel the same way my clients and I do after being hypnotized. But like any profession, you have the good and the bad. For example, most of the physicians I have interacted with have great bedside manner, but I have met a handful over the years who I would never let my family and friends visit. I used to have a list on my refrigerator of physicians that I did not want help from under any circumstances. Since the question asked was, how do you feel after a hypnosis session? I assume that Josh hasn't been officially hypnotized yet. When looking for a hypnotist, ask your friends and family for a referral. If your friends and family have no suggestions, ask your doctor. Search online for hypnotists. Look at their websites, read their reviews and testimonials, and pay attention to how they present themselves online. Trust your gut. If you don't get a good first impression, move on. Take a friend. I encourage my clients, especially my female clients, to bring a friend with them. This makes the client more comfortable and relaxed, and it keeps the hypnotist safe from false allegations. Be okay to walk out of the session if you feel uncomfortable with the hypnotist at any time. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, comment below, and click subscribe. Remember to ring the bell so you receive notifications of new videos. Also, check the link below in the description for valuable free resources.